What is up, guys? We are back. We've got the Ghost Loki S1 case. We got a Noctua NHL965, baby. Hopefully she fits in here. I didn't look at the measurements. I should have when I bought this. I bought the bigger of the two low-profile coolers, so we got that for the CPU. We got a B450i gaming motherboard. Hopefully we can get some overclocking out of it. I know MSI isn't the best for overclocks, but we are still going to push what we can from it. We've got 1 terabyte SSD, old school, and we got NVMe SSD at 1 terabyte as well. So we'll at least have 2 terabytes. I'm going to see if I can't cram a hard drive in there, but I don't think I can. But if I can, we have a Seagate 3 terabyte Fire CUDA. So, pretty quick little hard drive. For RAM, we have G-Skills Sniper X DDR4 at 3600. Really trying to make use of RAM speeds with the CPU. We got a Ryzen 1700X. This was pretty much a bargain bunch that I made here. Got the screwdriver, so we'll go ahead and get in here. Come to think of it, I don't think the screwdriver is going to work anyways, because these are all star bit. Specialty screws.
It's not about winning. It's about fun.
What's that?
What is fun? Let me spell it for you. Friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. N is for anywhere and anytime at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
It's completely idiotic.
So I've been having nothing but problems with this Loque case. The Ghost S1. Supposedly one of the best cases you can get. One of the most expensive cases you can get. So you'd think it would be, you know, at least well developed for the price they ask. I think it was like almost $300 just for the case. And then like another $100 for the freaking top hat, which I still haven't gotten. I ordered this shit 4 months ago. Okay. They delivered the case. And then they attempted. Okay. That's what the tracking information says anyways, to deliver the top hat. They sent them separately. Okay. And I never got the top hat. 4 months they've had. Okay. I get they have issues with shipping with Amazon or whatever. That's their fault for being dumb and not doing it in-house. So take the easy route. And then the cables for the power button are too short. They don't reach my motherboard's pins for the power or reset. Like, what kind of horseshit is this? You guys are charging a premium price. This product should be premium. And it's not. This is the materials. Yeah, the materials are nice. The finish is nice. But the actual, like something as simple as the wiring for the button. Okay. Like, come on. I cannot express how disappointed and frustrated I am with this company right now. Okay. All the YouTubers that have done reviews on these, the companies personally mailed their stuff, I guarantee it, and tailored it to them. And for people like you and me that aren't, you know, a YouTuber, that don't have a huge effect on their product, it really seems like they're saying just fuck you. Because it's like, I've gotten almost no support from them. I got a message telling me what I already knew, that they have issues with their shipping from Amazon. I have 3 weeks of leave and then I go back to work. I go back to base. So it's like this is not cool. Okay. Loque, you need to get your act together. Your product, as far as I'm concerned, is a heaping pile of shit. So.
All right, guys. I don't know if you can see it here, but it's all dark. It's running for the test boot. I don't have a monitor up here, but I had to use this little test switch for power because the stock cables for the case don't reach my motherboard. But let's see here. I got it mocked up with a Radeon HD 7770 from like 2011. Use that to mock it up. And it looks like the fans are spinning. Everything's working good. So, put the side panel off. It does fit. The side panel does fit. Left it off because I'm going to end up having to take this apart again tomorrow. Put another card in. So, but it does run. Probably take it down tomorrow morning and test it on the monitor, make sure picture comes up just the way it is, and see what the CPU is doing, and the RAM and all that good stuff. So super excited though. Little shoebox case. Oh yeah. See ya in the morning.
Came out pretty good. The Noctua cooler is working fantastic. I haven't seen temps above 54 degrees. And that's under load with Cinebench, so that's pretty fantastic. I'm very happy with that. I had to use cable extensions to get the front power to work, which is frustrating. That's definitely an issue Loque needs to solve. They're a pretty crappy company as far as companies goes. I've had nothing but trouble with them.
I got the Vega 64 card in here. This is the Frontier Edition, 16 gigs of HMB2, which is awesome. So yeah, I'll go ahead and slap the side panel back on and the top. I just kind of took it off to show you guys the inside. It literally slides together here. It's pretty cool. If I can get it to go in one-handed, that's what she said. But yeah, it's tough.
We'll go this way, and then... Ooh, I'm going to get this. Don't worry, guys. There we go. Slides right in. Bam! Nailed it. Move my Ethernet antennas out of the way. I don't use those because I'm hardwired. And then this sucker... Whoop! Drops in. It's got magnets on all four corners. You can see the little shiny silver parts there and there, and it's the same on the other side. And this sucker just kind of pops right in. And I mean, there's screw holes too. They mount in, but I just use the magnet in case I have to take it off for whatever reason. It's more convenient. But yeah, this is what it looks. It's the finished complete build. I'm not getting the top hat because they haven't sent it. They've just been really shitty about giving me my top hat. I just today told them that to just give me a refund. I'm tired of waiting and getting excuses. So we'll see what happens with that. But this is big. We got it running. Runs great. Finally got it dialed in. I did have a lot of issues with this system. Overheating. And it was intense. So I had to redo thermal compound on the graphics card. It was actually like insulator. It was so dry and thick with the stock application from AMD. I was very surprised. So I did that, and then I had to use Group C BIOS in the Vega BIOS suite under the AMD settings, which was kind of interesting. That was the only one that gave me a stable run, and I had some issues with crashing, but I got it dialed in now. I think it was due to power consumption, so, but we'll see. It's been running great. I haven't had a crash in a hot minute, so it's been good. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think. Like, comment, subscribe, ask questions. I'm here for you guys. I do check my email pretty regularly. I do get notifications. So let me know what you think, and I will see you guys in the next one. Big. We're getting there.